Hi, this is Marcus and welcome to my channel. I'm going to be talking about two new updates that was released by DxO. DxO PhotoLab 9.2 and DxO Nik Collection 8.2. In DxO PhotoLab 9.2, we're going to talk about the new mask, improvement of labeling. We're going to talk about new photo filters. And for Windows, which I'm not using, they have improved the history panel for Windows, but of course, I won't be able to show you that because I'm working on a Mac. In Nik Collections 8.2, they've released a new feature within that application of Analog Efex, which is called Paper Textures. I'm going to go over all of these features and show you how they work. And I'm also going to be showcasing my new presets that I have just released for Analog Efex. I've been working on them for over a month. They've been meticulously designed to work on a whole range of different photos. And when I got the information that they were going to be releasing the new feature in Analog Efex of paper textures, I was able to include three or four presets that actually use that feature as well. So sit back and enjoy, and let's get started. Hi, welcome to this video on DxO PhotoLab 9.2, the new release. There are three new features that have been released for 9.2. One of them happens to be specific for Windows. I am using an Apple computer, so I can't show you that feature that is available for Windows, but I can tell you what it is. It's a feature that's already contained within the Mac OS, which allows you to have a history panel to remember every step and every edit that you've done within the software. They've now included this within Windows as well. So what I am going to do is show you the new photo library filters. And basically, I can go under here, and now there's a new filter that says, show me all edited photos. If I click this, this will show me the photos that have been edited. Now, what you have to do is you have to unclick it. Because if I don't unclick it and I say, show me the photos that are unedited, it'll show them both together. So what you want to do is you want to reset this. Let's see. So these are all the photos that have been unedited. And then if I go back here, I want to either reset or declick it and say, now show me the photos that are edited. And then I'll go back in here again and reset it again and go back and say, show me the photos that are edited with local corrections. And it shows you that. Unedited, edited, and edit with local corrections. Let's go ahead and reset this. And now let me go ahead and just choose a photo really quickly to show you the new masking that they actually have. And in here, we're going to go down to local adjustments. I'm going to turn that on and I'm going to click on here for the AI features, for the AI mask. And if I go in here and tell this to select people, you will see that it did an extraordinary job in selecting. There's no halos, it selected the hair extremely well. And I can also change the order of submasks as well. So let's say, for instance, let's do this. Show you how this actually works really cool. We're going to delete this mask. Let's say I'm going to use this filter here to go ahead and select down like this. And what I want to do is I'm going to create a submask. When I create this submask, I'm going to tell it to select people. And it will select her with no problem. I have the ability to move these masks any kind of way that I want to move them. And so now that's been done a different way, right? So if I go back in here and I say I want to have that be masked out, you'll see how it's masked it out. It did take her off, but because the graduate filter is on top, it will actually still go over the subject. If I grab this here and put that to the bottom, Now you'll see that it's only doing it to the background now because of the order that I was able to change as far as the submask, which is really cool. It gives you a lot more flexibility now to move things around. And if we go back into here, let's go ahead and delete all of these masks. We're going to create a new mask again. And on this one here, what I want to do is I want to be able to zoom into this a little bit closer. Let's go into 75%. I'm going to pull this down and we're going to see just how well this mask hair. So we're going to go into this here and I'm going to tell it to just mask her hair. And you can see how well it did that. It's even getting the strings. It did a phenomenal job. Excellent job of masking. So they've really improved the masking. You don't see any halos. It's fine-tuned. And now I'm able to go in here and really just do some things. I can add micro contrasting to it, which brings out more detail of it. If I go ahead and do the clear view, you can see I can bring out more color of that. I can the midtones if I wanted to do that, or I can take the highlights down that's on the edges. And I'm able to increase the sharpness. So I can go in there and really bring out the sharpness of the hair. And it's not affecting anything else. So this is welcome adjustments to the masking feature, which does an excellent job. I hope this has been informative. And now we're going to go to Nik Collection 8.2 and the new features that they've included for Analog Efex 8.2. Hi. Welcome to a quick look at Nik Analog Efex, which is part of Nik Collection 8.2. There's been a brand new update that's been released and it's added a new feature within Analog Efex, along with some minor fixes to the software application. Let's go ahead and get started. Here, what you're going to see is a new feature, which is called paper texture. If I go ahead and add this right here, you'll see that when it comes up, it gives me the ability to have a blending mode. So I can go ahead and blend in the mode of however I want this to appear on my photo. It also gives me a strength slider. I can go all the way to 100% and I can go in the reverse and it'll show you that it gets those textures to mix much darker and makes them more prominent within the photo. We have a subcategory. These are the classic looking textures. If I go down, we have vintage. These are giving me different looks as far as vintage textures. And if I go to worn, that will give me textures showing that the photo appears to be worn. We're going to go back into the texture of vintage, and I'm going to select a texture. We have the ability to scale this texture. It comes in at 150% default. If I take it to 200, you can see how it scales. If I take it back to 100, it'll actually fit the entire image and it brings back the edges of those textures. I have the ability to flip it horizontally or flip it vertically. I can colorize it. If I go into here, I can actually pull the hue and choose whatever color that I want to use for that photo. I can desaturate it, or I can pull a little bit of saturation in, and I can also use the luminous or the luminosity on the photo to make it darker or make it lighter. Let's go ahead and make it darker. And there's also a neat feature that they have in here with the local adjustments, which means that I have the ability to drop a control point. And I'm going to drop a control point here. And when I scroll down to look at what that control point is actually affecting, I'm going to actually hit this to show me what it's affecting. I have the ability to do a more control mask of what it's affecting. So if I pull the luminous, you can see that's a little bit more fine detail, but I can take the chrominess in the opposite direction to smooth it out, or I can make it even more fine-tuned in a way of where the edges are not really diffused, they're really sharp. Let's go in the opposite direction here. And I can move the diffusion slider, makes it just a complete circle, or
I can pull it all the way over. So it's actually diffusing. So everything in white would be affected. Everything in black would not be affected. If I go ahead and take this look off, now if I go to the texture strength and take that to zero, you'll see that it takes it off or wherever that control point is at. I can actually hit this button here to duplicate it. And when I duplicate it, it's going to take on the same parameters as the one that I duplicated it from. Or I can hold down my option key and click in the middle. And now I can drag it to wherever I want to drag that to. And then I can go back to the selection here on the local adjustments, select all four. And if I want to change the strength for all of them, I can just now move the strength and it'll change the strength for all four local adjustments. And what that will do is allow me to be able to reduce the amount of texture that's placed over the photo to my desired taste. And I still have the ability to add in the other components or the other filters that are contained within Analog Efex. So I could go in here and let's do a zoom rotation effect. I'm going to go ahead and put this here. I'm going to expand it out a little bit more. Let's expand this one here. And we have the ability to use that zoom effect. I can go ahead and grab this like this and turn it. And we can use the zoom effect if that's what I want to be able to do. We got the strength of 100%. I can lower that strength by pulling it in this way. We can zoom it however we want to zoom it or zoom it a little bit. Let's go ahead and add something else as well. Let's add a fem type. I'm going to go ahead and go in here and I'm going to add a black and white fem type. Now, when I go in here and add a black and white fem type, I have the ability to fade it to give more strength of that film type that I'm using. I can change the grain effect of that and I can still go within my basic adjustments. Let's pull in some extracting of detail. I am going to take the contrast in the opposite direction and pull down the brightness of this. And then let's do one more other thing. We're going to go into levels, and in levels we're going to add a little bit of color into the mid-tone. So I'm going to go to the blue channel and I'm going to push it up and give a little bit of the blue. And then if I go in the opposite direction, you'll see what that does. That brings in a little bit of yellow. And we can go into the luminosity up here, pull this down, lift this back up, and go back and pull that in. And let's lift it to give a little bit more fade to it and then pull this in. And so if we go, this is before. This is what I was able to create very quickly. This is before and this is after. I have recently developed 22 presets for Analog Efex. Prior to getting any information that they were coming out with this new version, I had been working on this for about a month. When I got the new information about the new feature that they're adding into this application of paper texture, I was able to do 3 or 4 presets using that new feature. What I'm going to do right now is go ahead and showcase a little bit of these presets that I have. I'm not going to go over all 22 for the sake of the time of this video, but I want to show you how they actually look. I meticulously designed these presets to work on a wide range of photos. And I'm going to go through some of them right now. And these are available as well. In the description, you will see a link where you can actually click on and purchase these presets for Analog Efex. I have some new presets also coming available for DxO Film Pack 8. And I've been working on those for about a month and a half, and I am near completion for those to be released as well. So let's click on the category of personal. And we're going to see the presets here. Now, what I've done is I've included a preset to say back to the original, which is really simple. If I want to remove all of these components here, I can just go to each of these modules and just start removing them or resetting them. But what I've included is a preset where you can just click on this and now we're back to the original. What I'm going to do is choose probably the first three to show you how they look. And then I'm going to scroll down to the bottom and show you some of those as well. So this one is called Analog Pulse. This one is called Blue Dreams. Let's get Dusty Real. Ghost Glass. Golden Reel, 1975. Let's scroll down to the bottom. Let's go with Sepia Dreamscape. Let's choose Silent Frame. And let's go with two more. Let's go with Time Traveler. And I'm going to scroll all the way down to the bottom and choose Velvet Shadows. Again, these presets were meticulously designed to work on a wide range of photos. I've taken my time and really made sure that I fine-tuned these, and I believe that they would be a welcome addition to anyone's collection if you're using Nik Collection's Analog Efex.